It is absolutely freezing. Put the heater on. Got myself a coffee this morning. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. All right, let's go. I've got to say, it is great, great weather for the ducks. We've had nothing but a drenching of rain, 50 mils of rain, something like that. I don't know, I'm not a weather guy, but a lot of rain and wind, absolutely freezing. Thank God I'm off today, no work today, guys. But as always, welcome to another video, and welcome to MGA Drive. Hope everyone has been well. The lockdown, the so-called coronavirus, is starting to ease here in Australia and Sydney. So I'm up early this morning, gonna film this video. I'm allowed to get out, which is nice as well. Even though the roads are wet, go for a little drive in Corgi and start the day off. I'm gonna say Corgi's going pretty well, considering some early mornings. I don't know what it is with this car. Hopefully you guys can see me. It's a bit dark out, the sky is definitely gray. What was I saying? Some mornings, early morning, or I should say first start, cold start with this car is never good. Oops, where to go? Well, the roads are wet. Bit of a front wheel slip, even though we've got the Michelins on, the power. Sorry guys, what was I saying? Yes, cold starts in the morning in the Mini JCW. I'm gonna say are quite bad in this car. I don't know what it is. Whenever I'm up early and I'm going to work, I'm starting the car. It's very similar to a misfire. You know, the car's coughing and splattering, and it's sort of like the idle's really low. And then eventually, once you sort of take off and you start driving, the car warms up, the car's fine, then it doesn't sort of splatter and all the rest of it. But yeah, it's quite odd. I've got to get it looked at. You know, as we all remember, we're doing the coils and, you know, the worn-up blast, and so it does, it's not a miss as in, you know, when you're driving along it's sort of stuttering. It's only really up on cold up start, so it's beyond me. I don't know what it is. I give up. So we'll see if I can nut that out in the next few weeks. And there's also a little bit of a noise again with the, hate to say it, but I don't know, with the suspension again. So it's like this car, whenever you fix something, it just bloody always comes back. So it's an annoyance. But the video about today is obviously of the Ford Focus RS, my Ford Focus RS. That iconic machine, the blue oval, the Ford badge, that distinct sound of the Ford Focus RS. Guys, I've got to say, I absolutely miss that car. You know, I haven't really sort of spoken about it. I haven't really sort of spoken about it too much. You know, with owning Corgi now, I think it's a bit over 6 months of ownership. And, you know, I've got to say, guys, I absolutely miss that car. You know, it was a great car, and there are days when I do hear one, or hear, you know, see one as well too, that, like I said, a distinct sound of the exhaust system on the RS was absolutely awesome, guys. You know, it was a great, great car. You know, it always put a smile on my face, and, you know, it's a perfect car for a day like today, the all-wheel drive, you know. It never stepped out on me once. It always made you feel safe. You know, you could put your foot to the floor in that. That 257 kilowatt, you know, it was absolutely awesome. And a few of you have been asking me as well, you know, what was it like daily? Do you miss it? Do you regret selling it? I've got to say, guys, at this present time, I don't regret selling it. Maybe if it was, you know, still fresh after selling it, I'd probably say yes. You know, whenever you let something go and you know, still fresh in your head, you think, geez, I shouldn't have sold it. But I'd have to say probably no. You know, with the weather like today, the elements, you know, the sun, the wind, and everything else, you know, I live in a pretty leafy area, as you can see, and I'd feel pretty bad for the car if it was still outside. You know, still no garage, still no carport. You know, I feel bad for Corgi, and, you know, Corgi's an older car. So in that respect, I'd probably say no, I don't regret selling. absolutely miss it. You know, I guess, you know, I miss the sheer power of it, the performance side of it. You know, whenever you put your foot down or, you know, put it in sports mode or whatever it was, I miss that side of the power. Another thing I probably miss as well too is, you know, owning a new car, the reliability. You know, like we were just talking about, I had a few problems with Corgi again. I miss that side of it, owning a new car, having warranty, not have to worrying about dailying the car, just sort of still getting in it, push the start button and away you go, and you got that you know, that new bit, and you've also got the fun bit as well. So I definitely miss that side of it. Probably the other thing I do regret about the RS as well too would have to be, you know, not having enough time with the car. For me, I wish I had more time to put, you know, a track day in on it, a hill climb, just to sort of get, you know, to understand the car at its full peak capacity, you know, just to take it out on a track day and you know, stiffen up the dampeners, put it in track mode and just go basically, you know, hell for leather and see, you know, open it up and really see what this car could do, because that's what it was made for as well too, guys. It was made for the track. You know, it was a great car. It was an iconic machine, like I said. You know, to think that this thing, when it came out, you know, it actually had a drift mode. I'm pretty sure Ford were the, you know, the first people to come out with that mode, and now you got people like Mercedes with the A45 following, you know, Ford's footsteps, which I think is pretty, pretty cool. Not that I had much, you know, time to, you know, to put it in drift mode. I think I probably used it once or twice, being cheeky on a, you know, in a car park somewhere, but it was quite cool, I'm gonna say. You know, such as the launch control, I gotta say, I did use that a fair bit, and probably scrub out the tires as well. That was, you know, the drift mode, I can't even talk. The launch control was bloody awesome, I gotta say. It really threw you back in the seat, and definitely had some punch once you put it into launch control. Guys, probably the other side of missing the Focus RS would have to be the memories. I think it could have been my first video or second video that I ever did on YouTube, and you know, with getting the content out there and, you know, wanting to share and the experience of daily in a Ford Focus RS. So I miss that side of it. You know, I remember my first video was, you know, getting up super early with my daughter and flying down to Melbourne, Geelong, to go pick up the RS, and you know, it was quite exciting for me and my daughter. You know, both of my kids and my wife as well too, they were pretty excited when I said, you know, I'm gonna go buy the Ford Focus RS. So I guess the love, you know, for the RS sort of started with a little Ford Fiesta ST. That was a great little car as well too. Very similar to the Mini JCW, very renowned for its handling, that go-kart feeling when you drive. So after owning, you know, the little Fiesta ST and then wanting the Ford Focus RS, because it was definitely a hype there, the car was still new. You know, it was 2017, everyone wanted one, I wanted one. So I was definitely pumped to get it. You know, I think we had something like 11 hour drive to get this car back from Melbourne to Sydney, and I thought it was a great way to, you know, first time to put it on my YouTube channel. So I miss that side of it, guys, definitely, you know, with owning that Focus RS. Also too, guys, that the rumors going around, you know, they are probably true, they're probably not rumors, about the Ford Focus RS not being made anymore. Apparently, you know, a lot of it is to do with the emissions. Everyone is going green. You know, with the emissions, I'd say that the RS is, you know, pumping out probably a little bit too much as well too. That, the development side of things, the R&D, building a Ford Focus RS is costing Ford a lot of money. So it's quite sad, you know, to think that an iconic machine is going to be stopped. You know, I was looking forward to the next model coming out as well too, and I'm sure a lot of you as well too. So a little bit, you know, disappointed there with Ford, but I guess, you know, maybe in time another model will come out. I'm sure that they will develop something down the track. So the question that you are probably all wondering, could I see myself in another Ford Focus RS in the near future? Guys, I'd probably have to say yes. Definitely, you know, if I was in the right, you know, right setup, right frame of mind, had a carport, had a garage, and, you know, all my cards were lined up and it was all good to go get another Focus, I'd have to say definitely without a heartbeat, I'd own another one in my driveway for sure. Absolutely love them. But guys, I hope you've enjoyed that video. Just a little bit of a, you know, a recap on the Focus RS. To all you Focus RS lovers out there, you know, or follow you guys still on, you know, Instagram or on YouTube or whatnot. You know, whenever I see something about the Ford Focus RS, you know, it always still sort of turns my head and, you know, it's always, like I said, a special part of me. So, hope you've enjoyed this video. As always, take care of yourselves. If you haven't already, please give the video a thumbs up, or if not, hit the subscribe button. It definitely helps out the channel. But definitely catch you on the next one, guys. Stay safe and see us.
Weapon, it's a cracker, it's blue, and it's a beast. It's a good one.